The reality of growing older over the age of 60. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Breanne. Well, I got to thinking about the reality of growing older today. I wanted to call it the harsh reality of growing older, so perhaps I will title it that, but there's also a very good side to growing older, so I want to cover that as well. First of all, I don't give information, I don't give advice, I don't give suggestions, I don't give recommendations. I just share with you my perspective on different topics, as is with this one. I just did my 5-mile run. I'm a sweaty mess. It is hot and humid out here. Very, very hot and humid. I like to leave my doors open during the day because I like fresh air, and then we put air conditioning on at night. My husband is a big air conditioning person. I love fresh air. I think the fresh air comes from when we lived in Europe and we all did what we called lufting our houses, meaning we opened up our windows and let the fresh air come in. Well, I wanted to talk about the harsh reality of growing older and the good side of growing older, okay? And I'm gonna give you my perspective on growing older. As you all know, I turned 64 about 2 weeks ago, and I'm very much into fitness, health, holistic approach. I don't give recommendations. I'm very much into eating the right foods and staying away from the wrong ones. I'm very much into the right habits in life. I'm very much into being proactive in a positive way so that I can live out my best life. And yet, there's another side to the coin too. And I wanted to talk about that. First of all, I kind of wanted to cover the health issues. You know, if you've had bad habits, say, you know, a lot of bad habits, I don't want to name specific bad habits, but let's say you had bad health habits prior to the age of 60, it is very likely that you could see the fallout of those bad health habits as you go into the 60s or even earlier. I've known a lot of people that had very bad health habits that did fine up until around the age of 60, and then they began to see the results of those bad health habits one by one. Sometimes people take meticulous care of themselves like I do, and yet there's some things that cannot be avoided. I know someone who was around 72 years old, perfectly fit, ate only perfectly in their life. They were meticulous in what they ate. Their weight was very perfect. They didn't have any bad habits, and yet they ended up having a blockage and had to have a stent put in somewhere near their heart, I believe. And so they did everything right. So you have people that did everything wrong, and you have people that did everything right. I believe, though, that when we do everything right to the best of our ability, I believe that often we will see far better results than if we do everything wrong. So we want to stack the deck, so to speak, in our favor by having right habits prior to the age of 60, as well as throughout all of our years over the age of 60. And, you know, I'm a person that has never liked going to the doctors. And I respect doctors, but I didn't want to ever have to go to them. I feel like for me, I only want to use them if absolutely necessary. And, you know, and I'm very proactive in my health. And so for me, it was so long that I had been to the doctors that when I called up my doctor to go in, they had to consider me a brand new patient and a lot extra time because it had been so long before I had gone in. So now I kind of go in a little bit more often just so that I don't have to go in as a new patient. And some of the things that I've seen in people over 60 is, you know, hip replacements, knee replacements, their shoulders have had to have surgery on it. Little things can go wrong that we never noticed before. For example, my eyesight. I never had to wear glasses, and then at age 62, I started wearing reading glasses. I started wearing those readers and prescription, and then I decided to go off of them because I didn't like that feeling of wearing glasses, and I can read without glasses, and yet I have to strain a little bit to do so, which I think is remarkable for age 64. So I have an optometrist appointment, an ophthalmologist appointment, and I'm going to talk to them about someday potential something similar to LASIK surgery, where you don't have to wear glasses at all. Now, I'm hoping that I don't need that in the near future or maybe ever at all, but I'm going to discuss it. And so for me, one of the things I've talked about, and friends have told me this, is that your doctor becomes your best friend over the age of 60. And I've said that many times before, that sometimes, you know, there are things that no matter how proactive in life we are in taking care of who we are, which is a wonderful thing, sometimes there are things that we need medical care for. And that's why it's important to have competent, right doctors specifically for whatever is going to be our issue if we need it. And if we need medical care, medical intervention. And so I think that having great doctors, having knowing what hospital you would go to, these are things that often younger people don't think about, but people over the age of 60 think about. How far away are you from the hospital if you were to ever need it? Do you have competent, good doctors that you can rely on? You don't want an incompetent doctor or one that is, you know, not going to take you seriously. I think having an advocates with you, and when I say an advocate, just someone to go along with you, sometimes to a doctor's appointment or to a, you know, if you had to go to the hospital. I can tell you from my experience, you get treated very differently when there's someone else in the room. Now, I'm not saying with all doctors and I'm not saying with all nurses, but there is a different level of being how we're respected and treated, I believe, when we have someone even just sitting in the chair next to us. When I had my health crisis 10 years ago and ended up in the hospital, and I've talked about that, that's called brain aneurysm. It's a video I did where I ran into a wooden hanger and at blunt force. And I can tell you when my husband sat there in the room and didn't even say anything, there was a different level there. Now, even though I'm a great advocate, I'm the best advocate I think anyone could ever have, but I believe that we cannot advocate for ourselves as well, nearly as well, when we're in a vulnerable position. So I don't care who you are, it's important to have an advocate, even if that advocate stays silent, to have someone that people know is aware. When my mom took sick and had to go to the nursing home at the end, I was there 3 times a day making sure everything was right. And she got great care because they knew I was watching over. And so I think having an advocate is definitely something that we want to do. I think being over the age of 60, knowing that there may be a possibility at some point we will have to have medical intervention at some level of some kind. And I think that's very important to understand that what we might have been able to get by with earlier on in life, we may no longer be able to get by simply on our own. And so for me, I have a lot of doctors, but I have doctors in place if I were to ever need them. A great dentist, always a great dentist. I go for regular dental care. And, you know, taking care of your body is a must. I think, you know, I run 5 miles a day. Sometimes it's waddling, sometimes it's walking, but I'm out there every day, 5 miles a day. And I'm not suggesting that to anyone. And I am also vegan. I'm not suggesting that to anyone. I'm saying that I eat healthy, in my opinion. I exercise, and yet I let myself also have fun and be good. And if I want that piece of cake, I will go ahead and have it. If I wanted a hamburger, which I don't eat meat, but if I wanted it, I'd let myself have it. I'm not going to deny myself within reason what I want. I'm going to enjoy my life. I'm going to enjoy my life more than ever, doing many of the things that I love to do. And I think, you know, there's a beautiful side to being over 60. A lot of times you have free time, you can travel, whereas before your whole life was built around your career. A lot of times your kids are now grown and you can enjoy them in a different way than having all the responsibility that you did. I loved raising my children. It was a magical, wonderful time. And I'm so glad that I had that time. And yet having them as adults is much easier than having them as little kids. There's less responsibility. And, you know, the downside too of growing older, sometimes people move away. Sometimes our kids move away. Sometimes relatives move away. People die, friends die. I have a friend, she's in her 90s, and she said she's the only one she has left from her age group. And even though she has younger friends, friends from different generations, she has no one long-term from her own generation. And so we can see that over the age of 60, we can lose relatives, we can lose friends, we can lose acquaintances, life changes on us, people move away, a spouse can pass on. There are losses over the age of 60. And I think the more prepared we can be for those losses or those eventual events, the better. It's not to say that they're going to be easy, but if we're prepared for them in some way, in some capacity, often we do far, far better. And so I'm not saying that over the age of 60 is all bad, because it's not. I think if you've taken great care of yourself or continue to, you know, start taking care of yourself, I think you can lead a wonderful, amazing life. I think prior to the age of 60, taking care of your finances, making good financial decisions, taking care of your health, taking care of your relationships, having a good plan for the what ifs. You know, don't live in the what ifs. Don't live in fear. Live in happiness. You know, fear will hold us back from our best life. Unhealthy fear. Now, there's healthy fear, like a bear running through the woods, and that's a healthy fear. That's a good fear, you know, for us to get out of its way. But unhealthy fear is the kind of fears that hold us back from stepping out towards our best life. And so we want to live out our best life. And sometimes the best years are our golden years, as they call them. And yet we have to remember that the golden years can have some obstacles to them that maybe earlier on in life, we didn't have those obstacles. And so understanding the potential obstacles over the age of 60, I think is very important. So either we can navigate through them, around them, or completely avoid them. And, you know, some people make it all the way through and never really have any health crisis, financial crises, relationship crises. Some people, it happens towards the very end. I know a couple right now who are, one's in their 90s, one's in their 80s, and they're really going through health crises right now, really for the first time in their life. So they've been very, very fortunate. And so this is the key. Whatever age you are, enjoy yourself. Live an amazing life. Follow your dreams. Follow your journey. Do the things that make you happy. The years go by really fast, and over the age of 60, it seems like they accelerate. They even go faster. And so you want to enjoy life to the max. You want to do the things that you love. So for me, if I want a piece of cake, I go ahead and have it. If I wanted that hamburger, I would have it within moderation and within reason. Even though overall I'm vegan, overall I take meticulous care of what I eat. I am very health conscious, proactive in the most positive ways, and yet I let room so that I can enjoy my life as well and enjoy those simple things, those simple pleasures of life. And so I think also with older age comes wisdom that we didn't have when we were younger. We also already check marked off many of those boxes, so we don't have to go back and check mark them off. And even though I'm a 64-year-old full-time college student, you know, I'm going back for fun. I'm going back for fun. It's not because I have to. And so a lot of times over the age of 60, we can do things for fun instead of because we have to. So there's a lot of beauty in growing older. There's a lot of fun growing older. There's a lot of great moments and a lot of great years and a lot of great times. So make your over 60 years fabulous by making great decisions from A to Z in every way possible. And remember, if there are obstacles, find ways to navigate through or around or avoid those obstacles so that you can live out those golden years, those wonderful years, those over 60 years fabulously. Enjoy life. Get busy enjoying everyday life. From my house to yours, I hope you like, share, subscribe to all 5 of my channels. Links are pinned to the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me, I will likely connect back with you with all 5. May God bless you, and I hope to talk to you soon again. Bye-bye.